So now we are going to start with the deep structures of the neck, and every time we study a cranial nerve, I am going to revise the functional components of cranial nerve for you, unless you know all of them by heart. Because we keep on forgetting, there are efferent components, there are afferent components. Efferent components is general somatic efferent, whenever muscles develop from somites and the nerves supplies it, 3, 4, 6, 12. General special visceral efferent, this is when it supplies, the nerve supplies muscles developing from pharyngeal arches. This is somatic general visceral. So 5 supplying the first arch, 7 supplying the second arch, 9 supplying the third arch muscle, 10 supplying the muscles of the palate and larynx. No talking. Ho gaya? Last bench. Baat kar. Should I continue? Okay. Take. General visceral efferent. This is parasympathetic. This is parasympathetic. Okay. So third now supplying the iris, 7, 9, 10. 7 supplying lacrimatory gland, 9 supplying the parotid gland, and 10 supplying the afferent components. The afferent components, general somatic afferent, this is for the fifth nerve, fifth cranial nerve. General somatic afferent. All skin sensations, proprioception. Special visceral afferent, this is for taste. 7, 9, 10, supplying the tongue. Okay? And general visceral afferent, this is for 9 and 10. This is afferent from the viscera. Okay, I'll be talking about this again and again, don't worry. So now we start with how you are going to write a cranial nerve. In the cranial nerve, we firstly write the functional components. After we write the functional components, then we talk about various nuclei in that nerve. Then we start about the course. How do we write the course of a cranial nerve? From the nuclei starts intraneural course, that is inside the brainstem. How is the course? Then we talk about where does it appear on the brainstem, appearance on brainstem. Then brainstem. Then intracranial course. Intracranial course. Then exit from the foramen. Exit from the foramen. Which foramen does it exit? Then next, extracranial course. Extracranial course. And then next comes the muscle supplied. Then comes applied anatomy. Then comes the applied anatomy. In applied anatomy, how does a nerve is damaged and what are the effects of paralysis? This is the format in which we write a cranial nerve. Okay? Functional components, nuclei, course is how it starts from the nuclei, intraneural course inside the brainstem, how it appears on the brainstem, intracranial course after appearing from brainstem till the foramen, what is the course, then exit from which foramen, then extracranial cores, then the muscles applied, and then we talk about the applied anatomy. So this is the format in which we are going to describe the cranial nerve.